What is up, guys? Here I am with a double review of Gintama with chapters 598 and chapters 599. We're one chapter away from chapter 600, and I can't believe we're nearly at that. Gintama has come such a long way, and I'm so proud because of that. Even though it's come such a long way, you know, like I said, every story has to have an end. So, going with chapter 598, you know, Odd Jobs is back in Kabuki-cho, and they're helping Otose and Ote and everyone around there to defeat the Liberation Force, because basically, to be simple, the Liberation Army is nothing but bullies who's using their authority that they're gaining from higher-ups in order to, you know, pressurize and so-called protect the people in Endo Japan from the Tendoshu and from Yutsuro. But they use their power and abuse it in order to put fear in the people and basically revert them back to what happened 20 years prior to the storyline when the Amato first invaded Japan. Now Gintoki and the crew are fighting them, and we have very funny, very various parts that were very funny in this chapter 598, where like Gintoki's like, you can destroy this tunnel. I'm paraphrasing. You can destroy this canal, but you cannot destroy the ones between the liberation canal between the lady's legs. And Tama and Ote, they just slam two of those Liberation Forces army people into Gintoki, and then he's getting crushed by Ginoji's tank machine. And it's like when Soroichi Sensei said that he was gonna bring back everybody. You saw people that you have not seen since the Diva Force arc. Meaning we have where Katsuo and I forgot his name, but he acts like a tranny. He always calls Gintoki Ginko or something like that. He's back there. We have the one from the Benizakura arc, the lady who forged the sword for Gintoki. You're seeing a lot of these characters that you have not seen from the Diva Force arc, and even way before that. They're now coming back and helping Gintoki and the crew fight off these Liberation Force army. And it was just, this chapter was very funny from beginning to end. And there was even a part where, like, there was a part that really had me weak, where like Katsuo, remember the guy with the 7-3 parting? This guy, when he jumped off the building and was trying to impress the tranny guy, I forgot his name at the moment, he jumped down off the building, and then you see his leg just bent, and it's like this guy is not showing no signs of pain, like his whole leg is bent like a 90 degree angle, and I'm like, oh my god. Like, this chapter was funny from beginning to end. I mean, this chapter felt like the typical Gintama before serious stuff really get down. Like, it's serious, but at the same time, it's like the jokes and them just doing typical Gintama stuff, being silly, it just made the highlight of this chapter. So eventually they managed to drive them out, and by chapter 599 we see they were doing flashback for the most part of chapter 599, where we have before Gintoki, Kagura, and Shinpachi went back to Earth, they were talking to various people in the ship while they were having croquettes. Okay, they were eating croquettes and tried to make a metaphor out of croquettes, saying that the croquette is the earth, and then whatever surrounding it is the Liberation Force Army, and then after that it's the Tendoshu, and they were making many metaphors about that. But basically they were trying to find ways on how to get close to the Liberation and tell them to take them out of Earth, because if they do not and continue, you know, basically putting fear, instilling fear on the people on Earth, especially in Japan, because this is where it's all taking place, then they have no choice. The people in Japan has no choice but to retaliate. And you know, when it comes push to shove, if you aggravate or antagonize a person, don't be surprised when they act a certain way towards you. So they're trying to figure out plans on how to make them understand that we want you to take your forces out of our country. And then we come to see where the current shogun, Nobunobu, even though nobody likes him, we even see where Kagura, being her mischievous self, she ruins his meal by putting hot sauce and all of this stuff in it. Nobunobu is willing to sacrifice himself once again, but for the better good, and where he's going to be the negotiator for Earth in hopes that it will change their minds and take their forces off of Earth, because to them, they feel like we're putting Liberation Army forces on Earth is their way of saying they're protecting them from the Tendo Shu, and they're questioning like the motives and like, why are you saying that our ways are barbaric? But for them, but for the people on Earth, you know, they're suffering underneath them. But of course, they were able to drive them away for a temporary time. But they are more likely to come back with even stronger force. And we even see many times in chapter 599 where Nobunobu has to go to the bathroom after eating that meal. He even said that he had to hold in from using the bathroom for 3 days. That's how messed up his meal was. Like, Kagura messed him up. She messed up his digestive system. Like, she wanted to fool him and get back at him for what he was doing. So, basically, poison his meal. And while he, in return, he wants to do one final thing as the Shogun. And we even, like, the funniest parts in chapter 599 where they had many references of the Star Wars. And they said, you know, in order to understand outer space, let's watch some Star Wars. So that was a very funny part of chapter 599. So at the end of the chapter, you would have thought he was going to be very brave and everything. But his face was, can I ask you one more question? He said, and I'll give you my advice, do not make these people your enemy with Gintoki's back facing. And then he said, and can I use your bathroom, with the most serious look on his face. And I was completely done with this chapter. So it was pretty funny, both chapters, no lie. The funniest one had to be chapter 598. It was just really funny. So the next chapter that's going to come is going to be chapter 600, and we're going to see from there if they're willing to, you know, make agreements with the Shogun, or if they're going to disagree and there's going to be an escalating fight, even worse for the people on Earth, or they may have to do something completely different in order to completely remove them and try to find ways to prepare themselves against, you know, the Tendo Shu and for Yutsuro's coming to their homeland. So if you saw these two chapters of Gintama, please do tell me in the comment section below on how you felt about these two chapters. The links are in the description box, so you guys go check that out. And I'm Kimmy Chan of Anime Legends Podcast, and I will see you guys later. Bye.